This is a video on economics for the students of class 12, and we were discussing about the elasticity of demand. Let us continue with our previous learning. Before moving ahead, let us look into some of the numericals. The price of a commodity rises from rupees 4 to rupees 6. Now, since we know that there is a rise in the commodity, so as the question reads, your demand of the commodity will fall by 40 units and it has become 80 units. Now we know that original price is rupees 4. After the increase in price, now the price of the commodity is rupees 6. So the change is rupees 2. So rupees 6 minus rupees 4 gives you rupees 2. So this is your change in price. This is your current price and this was your initial price of the commodity. Now, if you see the demand falls by 40 units. Now, whatever is the demand, because of the increase in price, we know that the quantity demanded will be fall. So, the units now that is being ordered is 80 units. So, your final, or you can say the current quantity demand of the commodity is 80 units, and the change that has come in your demand is 40 units. That means the original quantity that was being demanded has decreased. So the original quantity will be the sum of the current commodity plus the change that has come in the fall that has come in the quantity demanded. So it comes to 120 units. Remember that the elasticity of demand has to stand the law of demand, which states that with increase in price, there should be a decrease in the quantity demand. With decrease in price, there has to be an increase in the quantity demand. Because we are considering the elasticity of demand, law of demand should stand. So since we know that there is an increase in price, so it should be very obvious to you when you're solving the sum that the quantity demand will fall. That means the original quantity will be more than the current quantity that you are purchasing. So this thing has to be kept in mind whenever you're solving the sums regarding to price elasticity of demand. Now we have all the values here, so you can put in it in the formula. So elasticity of demand will be your change in quantity by change in price into the original price by original quantity. So it comes to 0.67. Now you see that since the value or the elasticity of demand that you've got is greater than 0 but less than 1. So this comes under which you must remember, it's important for you to remember all the factors of the elasticity of demand, all the variables or all the consequence of the price elasticity of demand. So we know that it is an inelastic demand curve because the value of elasticity of demand is greater than 0 but less than 1. That means it is an inelastic demand. So we can say that rice has an inelastic demand. Similar to our previous sum, these are some of the numericals which I've bought for you. You can take the screenshot of these questions and try solving it. Be careful regarding the question, read the questions properly and try to analyze. I think it will be easier for you to solve. The formula will remain the same. Please try solving this sum. I'm sure you can do it. Factors affecting price elasticity of demand. This is the last point of discussion from this chapter. So let us discuss the points. Availability of close substitutes. A good having close substitute will have an elastic demand, and a good with no close substitutes will have an inelastic demand. For example, you can say commodities like pen, cold drink, they have close substitutes. So when the price of these goods rise, the price of their substitutes remain constant. So there is a proportionately greater fall in the quantity demand of these goods. So we can say that these goods, the demand of these goods have elastic demand curve. Now commodities like medicine, salt, they have no close substitute. So we can say that they have an inelastic demand or demand of the commodity. Next point is income of the consumers. Now if the income level of the consumer is high, the elasticity of demand is less. That means any change in the price does not affect the quantity demand by a greater proportion or proportion, but in low income groups the elasticity of demand is higher. So your third point is luxuries versus necessities. Now the price elasticity of demand is likely to be low for necessity goods and high for luxuries. That means if the price of any essential good like bread, milk, which are required medicines, if the price of these goods increases, you might delay in purchase, but you need those goods, so you are going to buy. So there is no the demand of change or the price elasticity of demand is likely to be low. But in case of luxuries, like if you want to travel by air or any visiting to a 5-star hotel, all these things, if the price increases, their elasticity of demand also increases and becomes higher. So we can see that price elasticity of demand, it actually talks about the change that is coming in the consumable level of a commodity. Okay, let's move on. Fourth point is proportion of total expenditure spent on the product. Now, higher the cost of good relative to total income of the consumer, more will be the price elasticity of demand. Now, if the price of bread, salt, ink, which is relatively quite low, doubles, it would have almost no effect on the quantity demand of them. Now, if the price of the car doubles, then the quantity demand will fall by a greater proportion, which will show a high price elasticity of demand. That means it basically is concerned about what percentage or what percentage of your income you are spending on a particular commodity. Now, if you for essentials, whatever is the price of the essential goods, you are going to purchase them. So you have a portion of money that you are ready to pay on that particular commodity. But now if the price of the car doubles its price, so you might delay your purchase or you might drop the plan of purchasing that particular commodity. So it becomes, your elasticity of demand becomes higher for those goods. Now next is number of uses of the commodity. Now more the uses a commodity has, it will have more elastic demand. If a commodity does not have any usage, in that case it has an inelastic demand. That means more is the use of a commodity. If you can use a particular commodity in various other things, that means you have an elastic demand. So more is the use, more elastic is the demand. Lesser the use, inelastic demand. Now last point of discussion is time period. Now if the time period needed to find the substitute of a commodity is more, the price elasticity of demand is less. Now like for example, today there are many substitutes available for petrol. So we know that it has an elastic demand. That is, if its price rises, demand will fall by a greater extent. But when no substitutes for petrol were available and its price was raised, its demand would have fallen by lesser degree. That means it would have had an inelastic demand. So if the price of a commodity which does not have close substitutes, in those cases, whatever is the price, the consumers are ready to pay because it's kind of a necessity good. So having a substitute of a commodity also affects the elasticity of demand. So with this topic, we come to the conclusion of this chapter. We've discussed a lot of things. Please go through the graphs. Practice a lot of graphs that we've practiced in this chapter. And next time we'll be starting a new chapter, most probably the production function.